A little bit starstruck right now because our next guest in studio is known as women's tennis hardest hitter. That's right. Lindsay Davenport is here. Aloha and good morning.
Hi, aloha. Thanks for having me.
You know, I could sit here and I would love to talk just your whole life, your history, and what you mean for USA Tennis, but we got to talk about an upcoming event that we all in Hawaii are very excited about, right?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. February 6th and 7th, the Fed Cup competition, the biggest women's team event, is coming to Kona.
Yeah.
And it's a great opportunity to see professional tennis in Hawaii, but also see some of the legends of the game. So far, Venus Williams has agreed. She's going to be on the U.S. team.
Wow.
We have some up-and-coming players, Madison Keys.
Oh,
obviously, fingers crossed for Serena.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't heard yet, but the team competition is so great. You don't see it often in tennis.
Yeah.
And so you're not only going there to cheer for the players, but you get to cheer for USA.
That's
and
right.
And that's always a great thing.
Again, what is that like? I mean, if anybody doesn't know, I mean, this is America's going against the world. You play series of countries, and again, this is such a rare opportunity to get behind USA. For the competitors out there, what does it for like a tennis when it's USA, when you're fighting for the fit? What's the change there?
It's such a big change. I mean, for instance, this will be the week right after the Australian Open,
mm-hmm.
so there's obviously a possibility that some of the U.S. teammates are playing each other, possibly for the title or from some of the latter rounds, and then you switch into team mode. And that's a great job of the captain, Mary Jo Fernandez, who does an excellent job of getting these players and getting them to eat together, to practice together. And by the time the matches start, Saturday, February 6th, you'll see them on the benches cheering for each other, trying to get the team. You know, the U.S. hasn't won it since 2000.
That's right.
It is a huge goal for the team to try and win it, and especially in an Olympic year. It's,
mm-hmm.
it's a very team-heavy year, and we've got some great players. We have the experience with Venus and Serena. We have young players, Sloane Stephens, Madison Keys. It could be a great year for Fed Cup, and it starts in Hawaii.
And talk about the venue, too, because, you know, the Kailua-Kona side of the Big Island where it's happening, it's a world-class venue, and you can really interact and get close to the players, right?
You will be so close to the court at the Halua Tennis Center, and it's a perfect seating. You'll be able to see everybody. The site is phenomenal. First of all, it's beautiful. The court is in great condition. And the biggest thing is the players. The players, their commitment and their excitement towards playing. But when you can go, sometimes you go to a Grand Slam and you see a player, but they're like, you know, 100 yards away. You're like, oh, I think I see them tossing the ball. Here, you'll be able to be within 5 feet of the players, get to really see them, and also hear the sound when they hit the ball.
I want to switch gears a little bit because we followed your career, and I got to say, I've the success that you've had, but also being to able balance a mom, being a great mom that you are. And again, I've always respected and loved that. Tell me, how many kids do you have?
I have four. So hold on to the great mom. Give me like 15 years when they're throwing parties and hopefully not getting arrested. But it's, you know, I feel really lucky. It's always a tough transition for an athlete to be in the middle in their prime and to be in the limelight and then segue out of it. And, you know, I feel really blessed with, first of all, a great husband and a happy marriage. And then all these kids that we now have. Four kids in, what was it, about 6 years was maybe a little ambitious. But it certainly keeps things interesting. And now my husband also played.
Yeah.
So we get to share kind of tennis with them and teach them and get to go through
and
everything.
And what's that like? I mean, being able to share that. And we were talking earlier in the first break. I have a 7-year-old son. And also, U.S. tennis is really focusing on the younger generations. I really noticed it over the time. And what do you think about U.S. tennis and that focus on the younger kids nowadays?
I love it. I mean, we're really trying to make a push of just getting more people to play. And the USTA has done a magnificent job with 10 and under tennis, where they have rackets of all different sizes. So for me, I have an 8-year-old, a 6-year-old, 3.5 and 1.5.
Wow.
So let's take the 1.5 out. She's not playing yet, but the 3.5. She has a 19-inch racket.
Mm-hmm.
My 6-year-old, she's got a 23-inch. And my 8-year-old, he's got a 26-inch. But it's perfect for their size.
Tennis is such an enjoyable sport. And I got to say, it's one of those sports that you can really kind of carry with you your whole life. I mean, do you feel that the same way is too?
Absolutely. I hope so. I hope my body's still old enough so I can play when I'm a grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I first had a racket in my hand at the age of 5.
Wow.
And from that moment, I always begged my mom and dad to keep letting me play. And the days I couldn't, I'd be hitting against my garage. So I've always felt really fortunate that I found tennis and I found something that I was so passionate about at a young age.
Mm-hmm.
And I love it. I can't get out of the business. I still go to these tournaments. I'm excited for Fed Cup to come to Hawaii.
Yeah.
I just love watching it. And it's a huge part of my life, and hopefully my kids develop that passion. If not, that. Hopefully we find what else is there.
Well, that's, I could sit here and talk to you for hours. Again, I love that you're here. And again, speaking of here, you've been to Hawaii a bunch of times,
we
right?
are. We're starting to get settled here. My kids are making a strong push for us to move here. So we'll see how that goes. But what's not to love about being here? It's
either
beautiful.
Way, we love what you've done. You've represented for not only women's tennis, but America for so long. Thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks for having
but
me.
But really, let's get out and support USA. Remember, we'll have all the information on our website. But for Hawaii to be so lucky to have the FedEx come here, get out there and get out there. I'm going to go and check it out. I promise you, I will be there. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you for having me.
I love this. I'm so excited.